सावधान। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑर्डर एंड मॉलिक्युलरिटी ऑफ द रिएक्शन। वी डिस्कस द लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन एंड द रेट लॉ। नाउ व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन एंड रेट लॉ, एंड वी हैव सीन दैट द लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन इज ए थ्योरेटिकल वन, but the rate law is the experimental one. From the law of mass action, we determine the molecularity of reaction, and from the rate law, we determine the order of reaction. We discuss about the different kind of reactions having molecularity 1, 2, 3, and also we discuss about the reactions having order 1, 2, 3, 0, even if we discuss about the reactions of fractional order. Also, we discuss about the difference between order and molecularity. So, difference between order and molecularity, difference between order and molecularity in this topic, we discussed that molecularity of a reaction determined from the law of mass action. From the molecularity order, so from law of mass action. And order we determine from what? From rate law. Law of mass action, this concept is a theoretical concept, and this is what you know, experimental concept. So order is what you know, experimental. Okay? And this just we are writing from the balanced chemical equation. From the balance chemical equation. And the molecularity of reaction is always a whole number. Whole number. That is 1, 2, 3. Order can be zero, fraction, and whole. Okay? And this is the sum of exponents. So with the reactants are raised in law of mass action, and this formula in rate law. Sum of the exponents. To which the reactants are raised, in rate. So these are the some differences we have discussed in the last class. Now we will discuss about the kinetics of first order reaction. Okay, kinetics of fast acceleration. So how to derive the expression for the rate constant of a fast acceleration? That is the integrated rate expression for the rate constant of a fast order reaction. Okay, now integrated rate expression integrated expression for the rate constant of a integrated expression for the rate constant of a first order reaction. So consider a hypothetical first order reaction. Suppose I have A gives us B plus C. A gives us value B plus C. It is a first order reaction. Let the rate logic R proportional to A. A power 1. Okay. So because R is on A power 1, that means this reaction is a first order reaction. That is order equal to 1. Okay. Now let the initial concentration of A is what? A mole per liter. That means, suppose we have taken A mole per liter of the reaction A at time t, let the amount of A consumed, which is x mole per liter. Okay, that is it. Therefore, concentration of A at time t is equal to what? Is A equal to A minus x mole per liter. And that of B and C divided to x mole per liter form. So initially I can write t equal to 0. We have A mole per liter. At time t, we have A minus x mole per liter. So x mole per liter is equal to x mole per liter. Okay, so here because the rate logic R is equal to d by dt equal to k a. So here from the rate law R equal to a, that is what R is equal to k into a. So R equal to d by dt is equal to k a. Now, if you integrate this equation from both sides, that value dx by dt equal to k into a. Now, integrating both sides, we will get value integration of dx by dt is equal to integration of k What A equal to 5 below A minus X. So what I can write? Integration of d phi dt is equal to integration of k into A minus X. Or I can write integration of 1 by A minus X dx integration of k dt. Okay? So integration of 1 by A minus X dx is equal to value integration of k dt. Now, if I take A minus X equal to suppose P, you know the derivatives. So d of A minus d of X equal to value dp. Now A is a constant, this becomes 0. 0 minus dx is equal to dp. So dx equal to value minus dp. Put here integration of 1 by A minus X equal to value p 1 by p d equal to value minus dp. And this value, I can write value minus integration of 1 by p dp is equal to integration of k dt. Okay? So now what I can write? Minus integration of 1 by x is equal to value ln x. So minus ln p equal to kt plus c. Or minus ln p equal to value a minus x. Equal to kt plus c. Question 2. So minus ln a minus x equal to kt plus c. And here c is value constant of integration. We can calculate from the initial condition. So initially when t equal to 0, x is 0. Therefore, minus ln a minus 0 equal to k into 0 plus c. So, minus ln a equal to c. Okay? Minus ln a equal to c. Okay? So, again, repeating, I am repeating here. So, a gives you b plus c is the first order relations I have taken. Let. I have taken the rate law is the r constant to a. That means r equal to k, because r equal to k into a, that means this is a first order reaction. Okay? So, suppose I have taken a mole per liter of a, initial when t equal to 0, and at time t, suppose x mole of a is consumed. Okay? So, the remaining concentration of a at time t equal to value a minus x mole per liter, at the same time, x mole of b. X mole per liter of P and X mole per liter of C is four. Okay, so we know the rate of a chemical reaction depends upon the active mass of the reactant. Okay, so here at time dt, when we are calculating the rate of the reaction, so at time dt, the active mass of A is what? A minus X mole per liter. So dS by dt equal to K of A. Or this will equal value. This a equal to a minus x, so I can put here. So by integrating, it is some this value equal to just of k. Or this a equal to a minus x. So, okay, because a minus x is the active mass of a at the instant of dt. So what I can write 1 by a minus x dx equal to integration of k dt. And this is for interest purpose, I have taken this one. So I will get dx by equal to minus dp. So I have put here minus 1 by a minus x equal to p I have taken minus 1 by p dp equal to integration of k dt, and we know integration of 1 by x dx is equal to ln x, so minus ln p equal to kt plus c. Okay, and c the constant of integration, so its value we can calculate from the initial condition. So when t equal to 0, x equal to 0, so minus ln a equal to c. Now put the value of both c here in this equation. In this equation 2, okay. So, putting the value of C, putting the value of C, putting the value of C in equation 2, we get a value minus log a minus x is equal to kt minus log a. Okay, this implies log a minus x is equal to minus kt plus log a or something. Okay, now from this field I can write, if I take this to this side, kt is equal to log a minus log a minus x. Kt is equal to log a minus log a minus x, or kt equal to log a by a minus x, or k equal to 1 by t log a by a minus x. Or k equal to 2.33 by t log a by a minus x. So k equal to 2.33 by t log a by a minus x. Where I can see what you log x equal to 2.33 log x. So I have to the rule of the log L log here. I am getting value 2.33 log. So k equal to 2.33 by t log a by a minus x. Equation 4. This equation 4 is known as the integrated expression for the rate constant of a first order reaction. Every first order reaction must have to obey this equation. K equal to 2.33 by t log a initial concentration by a minus x final concentration. Okay, so also I can add this is what will be k equal to, I can take k1 also for part reaction, k equal to 2.303 by t log a at 0 by a at t. When a is equal to what will initial concentration, and a is equal to concentration at time t. Also I can write, k equal to 2.303 by t log n0 by n. Okay, so here I can say a0 is what to initial concentration of a. This is also called what to n0. A at t is what to final concentration at time t, which also value n. Okay, so if we have the initial and final concentration, and if we have the time taken for this concentration to change from a to a minus x, then we can determine the value of k. Okay, so value of k is equal to 2.3 by t log a initial concentration divided by final concentration. Okay. Now this expression also we can express graphically. Let's see from this equation 3, equation 3 we have from equation 3 log a minus x is equal to minus kt plus log a. Now this is in the form of what y is equal to mx plus c. And y equal to mx plus c times 1 equals to a straight line. So here ln mx x you can take in the y axis, and time t you can take in the x axis. Okay, then minus k will be part of this slope, where ln a will be the intercept. So if you plot a graph, okay, ln a minus x versus t, you get a straight line with a negative slope. Your slope minus k. From here, you can draw the slope. Okay, so slope will have to minus k. Similarly, the same thing. If I can convert to log 2.303 log a minus x equal to minus kt plus 2.303 log a. So log a minus x is equal to minus 2.303 by 2.33 minus k by 2.33 t plus log a. So here this I can take as 0. Y equal to m x plus c. Y equal to m x plus c. So if I plot a graph with log m x x versus t, I will get a straight line with a negative slope is equal to minus k by 2.303. So if I take plot the graph log m x x versus t, I will get what? Straight line with a negative slope. Slope equal to what? Minus k by minus of k by 2.33. Okay. So in this way we can express the different determine the value of air constant from the graph also, right? Now let's see. For the path rotation, for first order rotation, we have r equal to r plus 1 to a. That means here, if I plot a graph for rate versus concentration, the increase in concentration directly increase. I get a state. Okay? So, this is what we look rate versus concentration for a first order reaction. Is that okay? Now, let us have the half life period. Half life period. Now, what is half life period? Half life period or the half lifetime is the time taken for the reactant to undergo half completion. Okay, so the time taken for the reaction for the reactant to half complete is called what, you know, the half life period. Okay, let's see. For a fast reaction, for a fast order reaction k equal to 2.303 by t log a by a minus x, where a is the initial concentration and a minus x is the final concentration. Okay, now when t equal to t half, so if the time half life t equal to t half, then x equal to 1 a by a half. If time is the half, then concentration is also half. Half. So what I can write? K equal to 2.33 by t half log a by a minus a by 2, x equal to a by 2. So you can what do? 2.33 by t half log a by 2. You can what do? 2.33 by t half log 2. So what I can write? Now, the k equal to 2.33 by t half into 0.3010. If I multiply this, I will get what? K equal to 0.693 by t half. This implies t half equal to 0.693 by k. So, for a first order reaction, the half life will equal to what? 0.693 by k. Okay? So this is called modulo. This is called modulo. Half life period. Okay? And this half life period is independent of initial concentration. Okay? So whatever may be the concentration of the reactor, so the time taken by it to half complete is called the half life. Okay? So for a first audition, the half life period is what you independent of initial concentration. Okay? Now see, number of half lives. See, suppose A gives C the product, first addition. Okay, A gives B plus C, suppose, and R equal what you know, K into A, first addition. Okay, now and initial concentration is what you know, equal what you know, A mole per liter. Okay, now at t half, in one half life, in one half life, in one half life, when t is t half, this a becomes value of a by 2, so a by 2 mole per liter. After this, again in another half life, the a by 2 will again become half. So a by 2 becomes again a by 2. So in second half life, it becomes what? So here a becomes 1 by 2 a. Now a by 2 will become 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 into a by 2. And you have a by 2 square. Okay. Again, in third half life, again, this concentration again becomes so 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 into a by 2 square. Okay. For what? A by 2 cube. Okay. Similarly, in n half-lives, n half-lives a by 2 power n.
Okay.
In 1 half-life, a by 2, 2 half-life, a by 2 square, 3 half-life, a by 2 cube, 4 half-life, a by 2 4, n half-lives, a by 2 power n.
Okay.
So what can I be? If n0 is the initial concentration, n is the final concentration,
okay,
small n is the number of half-lives, number of half-lives,
okay, then concentration after n half lives, then your n is equal to n0 initial by 2 power n,
like this.
Okay, so a is the initial concentration by 2 power n is equal to value the final concentration. Okay, so n equal to n0 by 2 power n. Okay.
And this n is equal to number of half life, number of half life n is equal to total time by half life. And what is n equal to t by t half.
N equal to t by t half is the number of half-lives.
So in a first order instance, if t half is the half-life period and if t is the total time taken, then how many half-lives have gone? N half-lives have gone. This is going to be given by what? T by t half. Okay? And accordingly, once you get the value of n, number of half-lives, in one half-life, the concentration becomes 1 by 2. So in n half-lives, it becomes what? Concentration initial divided by 2 power n. Okay, now let us have some numericals based on these formulas. Okay, so what are the formulas you got? Formulas number 1, we got value k equal to 2.03 by t log a by a minus x. Okay, so we got value k equal to 2.03 by t log a by a minus x, where a is value initial concentration, a minus x value final concentration. Also we can take the n0 and n. Number 2, we got value k equal to 0.693 by t half. Number 3, t half equal to 0.693 by k. Okay. Number 4, you got here value 2 power n equal to 0 by n. Okay. This implies value n equal to n0 by 2 power n. Okay. Now you see n is value, n is value final concentration, n0 value initial concentration. Okay. Now also can calculate the n, n equal value t by t half, total time by half life. So using this formula, so now we can solve some numerical questions. Okay. Suppose I will write a question. okay. A fast order reaction completes in 15 minutes. Okay. How long will it take for 75% completion? Okay. Let's see, a fast adoration 50% completion in 15 minutes. Okay. So 50% is what? Half life. Okay. So 50% completed equal what? Half life, and your T half equal how much? 15 minutes. Now, how long will it take for 75% completion? Okay. So here I can write initial concentration equal to 100, final concentration is what? 75% completed and what? Equal 100 minus 75 equal 25. Okay. Let me see, initial 100 is value N0 and final 25 value N. So we have 2 power N equal to N0 by N. Okay. This implies 2 power N equal to N0 how much? 100 by 25 equal to 4 equal to 2 power 2 simplifies N equal to 2. That means number of half life equal to 2. Now again N is equal to T by T half. N equal to what? T by T half. This implies T is equal to N T half. N equal to how much? 2 here. T half how much? 15 minutes. Equal to what? 30 minutes. So the time taken for 75% completion of the reason is what? 30 minutes. Okay? Is that clear? Number 2. Number 2. So that the time taken for 99.9% completion of a fast order reaction is 10 times the time required for 50% completion. Okay, so for a chemical reaction to complete 99.9%, the time required will be what? 10 times the time required for the half completion. Okay, let us see. Okay, time required for half compression. Okay, T half. T half equal to what? T half equal to what? 2.33 by K. Your log A by A minus X equal to what? 2.33 by K log A by A minus A by 2 what? 2.33 by K log 2. Okay, now time required. Or here also you can write 100 by 100 minus 50 equal to 50. Okay, now time required for 99% compression is what? T is equal to 2.23 by K log 100 by 100 minus 99.9. Okay, is equal to what? 2.33 by K log 1000 equal to what? 2.33 by K log 10 cube, okay, equal to 3 into 2.33 by K. Okay, and this I can also take here. This equal to 2.303 by K 0.3010 equal value 0.693 by K. And here I will get value 9096 by K. So here 0.69 by K, 3.9 by K. Okay, that is part 1. Now this T half by T 99.9 is equal to 0.693 by K, okay, divided by 6.90 by K equal to 0.693 by K into K by 6.9, okay, equal to what? 1/10. Okay, so T 99.9 is equal to, okay, 10 T half. Okay, so in this way we can prove that how this time required for the 99.9% compression of the reactions is 10 times the time required for the T half. Okay, number 3, okay, so next you see the T half of a fast reaction is 15 minutes. Okay, question number 3, so T half is what? 15 minutes. Find out the amount of substance left after 45 minutes. t equal to 45 minutes. If we start with 80 gram of the substance, okay? So A equal to 80 gram. Okay? Now, you know, K equal to 2.03 by T. So you can do like this simply. Number of half lives n equal to, you know, t by t half equal to value 45 by 15 equal to 3. Okay, now this your a, or you can say n 0. Okay, now we have 2 power n equal to n 0 by 10. And simple as n equal to n0 by 2 power n0. So n0 how much? 80 gram. 80 divided by 2 power n how much? 3 equal to 1. 80 by 8 equal to 1. 10 gram. Okay. So this value 10 gram. What is t have given? T given. And now n0 given, so we calculate the value. Number of half life equal to t by t half equal to 3. Then we calculate value 2 power n equal to n0 by n. Therefore, n equal to n0 by 2 power n, we get value 10 gram. Yeah. So, number 4, a fast runner recently found to have rate constant of this much. So, k equal to 5.5 into 10 power minus 14 second inverse. And what is your t half? We know t half is equal to 0.693 by k. Okay, so therefore your t half is equal to 0.693 by 5.5 into 10 power minus 14 second inverse. So on solving, we will get this one. Okay, 1.26 into 10 power 4 13 second. Clear? Now number 5. The initial concentration of the reactant for a fast oxidation was 1.2 × 10⁻²⁷ mole per liter. So A equal to 1.24 × 10⁻²⁷ mole per liter. The concentration of reactant after 60 minutes equal to value 60 minutes was this much. A minus X equal to value 0.20 into 10 power minus 2 mole per liter. Okay, so we have, and so calculate the rate constant K. We know K equal to what? 2.33 by T log A by A minus X. Okay, so what I can write? K equal to 2.23 by T. T how much? 60 minutes. Okay. Into log 1.24 into 10 power minus 2 divided by 0.20 into 10 power minus 2. Kilowatt 2.23 by 60 log 6.2. okay, given here the value. Okay, kilowatt 2.23 by 60 into 0.7924 equal to kilowatt 0.0304 mean not inverse the answer. Okay, so these are about the kinetics of fast order reactions. So in the next class we'll discuss about the zero order kinetics and some other kind of orders. Okay, thank you.